Real niggas ain't gotta show too much, nigga. I might come through on the low and a Rory, nigga. Sippin' Fiji water, nigga. You know what I'm saying? Living life, though.
Word around town, I got the bands right. Word around town, I bought that Benz right. Word around town, I got my shit right. Word around town, I got that big ice. I got my shit together, so you choosing now. I got my shit together, so you choosing now. I ain't winning. Pull up in a spaceship, limousine tinted. And I don't fuck with hoes, I fuck with women that stay on they shit even if they got children. Stand on my pivot. Larry, what you doing? Bitch, I'm back chasing. Gamed up, I can lace you. Eating on hibachi with a bitch named Rachel. Usually, crucially, this trap shit ain't new to me. I beat that kitty so good she got used to me. I got hoes in Beverly, bitch, I'm not settling. Juice with the celery, 10 in the magazine. Now a nigga in the A, I gotta bust some moves. Bought a North Face jacket and my son some shoes. Ride my bike in the morning, I never watch the news. I gotta stay focused, I got so much to do. No management, no label too. If I lost it all today, can I stay with you? I kinda doubt that, I got my clout back. I'm about to cop a 442 stock golden black. Cop a house in Twin Peaks and I'm owning that. It's just a dream right now, but I'm doing that.
Coming to you straight from the underground. Episode 4 of Underground Kings. We're going deep in the soil, under them citrus roots, and looking at the Yeehee himself, Mr. Sakatimi, organic, positive energy, Larry June. Larry June was born in one of the worst parts of San Francisco, and that is Hunter's Point. Now, at an early age, his mother moved him and the family down to Atlanta so they can have a better chance at life.
Good morning, bitch ass nigga. It's your boy Larry Jones, and you know I must stay healthy.
I'm from Frisco, Hunter's Point, California, man. Goddamn, but I was raised in ATL, spent a lot of time out there, came back to the Bay when I was 16.
When I go to the Bay, I was in the projects. I was born in Hunter's Point, you know what I'm saying? Harbor Road, like one of the craziest projects in Frisco, you know what I'm saying? So now I go to the Bay, and it was, I'm in the projects, you know what I'm saying? Grandma got the candy house, you know what I'm saying? I'm seeing all kind of shit.
Yeah, hey. For sure, I got a lot of ATL influence, a little bit, not lingo-wise, because I ain't been out there in that long, but the cadences and shit, I definitely, growing up hearing different music, and then the Bay Area shit, you know? Talk my shit, swallow spit, mac a bitch, pull up in a six, good job, Larry. You know what I'm saying? Game for a punk bitch. I was listening to Goody Mob. I was listening to T.I., all of them before they was even big. Jeezy, too. You know what I'm saying? I was hearing all that shit. Then I go to the Bay. We slapping RBL Posse. We listen to Mac Dre, E-40. So I'm always going back and forth. And I'm, you know, in the city, a beautiful place. You know what I'm saying? And growing up out there, I just learned a lot about, you know what I'm saying, the street shit. And how to move, and I feel like being around the OGs in the city kind of shaped me to be who I am today, more low-key and doing shit, because not what you do, it's how you do it, you know what I'm saying? And just moving in silence, you know what I'm saying? Learning.
I learned a lot, man. It's a lot of game in the Bay. Whole lot of game, so.
Born Larry Hendrix, Larry June wasn't really always Larry June. His father, Big June II, was a well-known street hustler from Hunter's Point. Now, when little Larry would come back and forth to San Francisco, the locals would call him Larry Jr., since him and his dad had the same name. Thus, Larry June was born.
Larry Jr., real name?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's my, they call me, but it's not my last name.
Oh, okay.
My last name is Hendrix.
Well, where did June come from then?
Because of me and my pops.
Oh, okay.
We got the same name, so. You know what I'm saying? I never met my granddad. I'm really the third. You know what I'm saying? But everybody called me Larry Jr.
Okay.
My pops got the same name. It's Larry June. Ooh, okay. Ooh, little Larry June. So Larry June is just a name that the people gave me that
right.
In my life at the time. And I just ran with it. I did go with the name Young June.
Okay.
And I spelt the June with a 3, trying to be creative.
I'm the third.
But I'm really June. But, you know what I'm saying? But that's kind of corny. You said Larry June. Fuck it.
You know, Larry June is some real legendary shit, man. You know.
That comes from the bloodline, man. You know, my pops was Larry June, man. So when I was younger, on the motherfucking block, everybody called me Lil June. My pops was Big June. So I said, you know what, nigga? I'm going to call myself Larry June. Goddamn, sock it to me. You're doing good. Let's get it.
Larry June was already into music at a young age. But when he turned 15, he officially moved out to the Bay Area. And when he moved out to the Bay Area, he soaked up a lot of game. And with him being a natural-born hustler, Larry June would set out to get it how he lived it, to support himself before the rap took off.
I'm trying to get some money.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? I'm a hustler, man. You know what I'm saying? If we get to a point in my career that I got to sell oranges,
yeah,
I'm going to open up an orange stand. Right now, I'm a Lyft driver, too.
You are?
I do Lyft on the side.
Really?
Worst come to worst, you got to have that just-in-case money.
Okay.
Just-in-case the trap stopped jumping. Went to jail, beat the case on them. My OGs called me Big Homie.
I was got a live saying? Performance.
Hey, look, man. I don't really do all the live gangster talk and I sold bricks to this. You know what I'm saying? People know me.
Right.
People know me, man. You know what I'm saying? Ask about me in the Bay, man. People in the Bay really know.
Yeah.
Cause before this rap shit, I was driving Benzes. I'm sliding through Beamers, condos.
Right.
Deep. I'm in Miami.
Yeah.
I got nigga. I'm 19 with 3 porn stars.
Really?
Seriously? It's documented.
Did you hear about that?
3 porn stars. What's the deal with the story?
You know, they used to call me like a little manager.
Oh, wait, you managing porn stars?
You know,
or were you saying you were a pimp?
You know what I'm saying?
Because pimping is still heavy up there, huh?
I ain't going to call it pimping, man.
Yeah.
But we go, you know what I'm saying?
We're definitely not incriminating ourselves today.
Yeah, man, it's all love. But hey, so I put a lot of time into it. I took 2 years of straight, literally trapping every day. I always knew once I had a chance to really just do it, I would go do it. But I know in the meantime, you got to have that meantime money.
Right.
You gotta have that meantime. So you can't just think you're gonna just depend on rap and make all this money. You had to have that meantime money. So I felt like I needed to put myself in position where I could invest if I needed to, you know what I'm saying, and do shit like that. So I put a lot of time into it. I took 2 years of straight, literally trapping every day.
Yeah.
I learned so much. I was in LA. I'm out the way. I'm in Anaheim. Meet me in Costa Mesa.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Look, hey, but people don't understand. Hey, people, I don't got to speak on this shit. Anybody that know what I'm talking about, when I say Anaheim and Costa Mesa, you know what I'm talking about, man.
Exactly.
I was at Disneyland.
Orange
with
County.
With the bitch. Yeah.
Even though Larry June was doing it big in the trapping and having it his way, he knew deep down that that's not what he wanted to do with his life. And that there was a bigger and better picture for him. But then something dramatic would happen in his life that would change him forever.
Months? How long a baby hose come out? Like 9 months? I said, I got 9 months to go try to do something. So I instantly sold my Lexus for the 1500, took that 1500, went to Arizona for a minute, you know what I'm saying? Tripled that a few times, you feel me? And I just been hustling ever since. I probably wouldn't be hustling as hard if I didn't have my little one. Good job, son.
Got 9 months to do something. So I was like, okay, what I'm gonna do?
What was the resolution that you made?
I was 22 years. I just went stupid.
Just nonstop doing nothing but profit maximization?
Yeah, designing my life.
Mm-hmm.
Figuring out who I wanted in my life. Figure out what I needed to do to be successful. Studying other people's success stories. You know what I'm saying? And keeping that vision.
How much fucking work are you putting in that people don't see when you're going this hard?
I got hours. I treat it like a job. So I taking rapping completely serious is probably like a year ago.
Oh, really? You know just a year?
Yeah, just a year ago. I dropped probably like just in 2015, I dropped 7 tapes.
7 tapes in 1 year, yeah.
So I'm a firm believer in just doing you, man. You know what I'm saying? Staying true to yourself and just sticking to it. You know, fuck with the right people, keeping positive people around you, making sure you stay working consistently, you staying consistent, and you know what I'm saying, focusing on being the best. That's all I can say.
Larry June is definitely the more unique artist coming out of the Bay Area. And I say that for a set of reasons. For one, he's not speaking on violence. He's having that positive energy all throughout his music, all throughout his career. And secondly, He's definitely one of the most consistent artists in the Bay Area. Go check out 8 Years Larry June. He's been putting out EP on EP on EP. Dude really on his grind. Another reason why he's definitely unique is because he doesn't really have an outbreak song. A lot of artists have that one song that put them on the map. And Larry June has been staying consistent, man, doing him. My first song from Larry June was 4 Deep, No Sleep. I talked to a lot of Larry June fans, and they all have a different song they heard that they got put on by Larry June. So with that being said, man, good job, Larry, man, for having a wide variety of music for different type of people.
We just want to stay successful, man, and keep everything real. Stay. My big thing with the music shit is staying me, the person I was before the music, and making sure I got my team that I've been with from day one and straight, and just keep pushing. I don't see how you can lose if you stay consistent. You know what I'm saying? Staying consistent and doing everything you got to do what you got to do.
Shout out Larry June, man, for real. I really like Larry June. I think I like his energy and his positivity and what he brings to the table more than his music. And he does more than music too. He's obviously a businessman, an entrepreneur. He has the T-Boba shop, a clothing line, a lot of stuff going on with him. So check out him. And I like that he doesn't necessarily talk about violence to get his point across or get his money in the rap game. He kind of has like a Wiz Khalifa fan base. You know what I'm saying? A lot of white people. But he does unquote unquote white people shit. And I do like going to the beach. I do like going for a jog early morning. I do like going in the woods. So I'm down for all that shit, man. I really like Larry June energy that he brings to the table. I also like his growth. This man has been growing for the last 8 years. And that's why you see the plant, the orange tree, in this short film. To show that he's been growing, man. And anything that doesn't grow is dead, for real. And Larry June has put his whole team on. The fruits of his labor, man. So it just goes to show you, you can grind hard without being negative, without talking violence or beefing. And be positive, man, and make it somewhere far. He reminds me of a Jay-Z as far when he was younger and to where he's at now mentally and financially. You know what I'm saying? The dude is really having it in his way. So shout out Larry June. Good job, Larry June. So go out there and support Larry June. There's many ways you can support him, whether it be music, whether it be clothing, whether it be supporting his tea shop in the Bay Area. Now, we usually end the UCK segment with the rapper music video, but today we're going to end it with a video of Larry just being Larry. This UCK, Underground Kings, we out.
Yeah, we're going to go fuck around at the Whole Foods, man. Grab a little something to eat, you know what I'm saying? Because you must stay healthy on the punk, bitch, man. We in the Bay Area, nigga, you know what I'm saying? We eat healthy. We fuck with bad bitches, we go hiking, we go biking, and we must do good, and you do know that. Sock it to me. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? That was a master one. Niggas won't even, niggas didn't know about that. Yeah, that's that. Sock it to me, put it in my hand, you know what I mean? Thank you, bitch, you're doing great. Numbers. Sock it to me. Ay, 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 ay. He believed that the orange gave him power, but he didn't really explain what the power was, so. Powerful oranges, nigga. Shit. He over there.
What Big Sean say?
You ain't getting richer every year, and you just backwards hustling. You know what I'm saying?